My name is Olivia. I'm a first year woman college, and this third part to Miss Bacon is faking. Currently on chapter 7, feeling the buns. Practice makes perfect. That's what Miss Bacon tells us. When I got home from school, I could have practiced playing my tuba, but I decided to play video games instead. Then I was going to practice my tuba after dinner, but there was a game on TV, so I watched it. Then I was going to practice my tuba after the game was over, but I had to clean my room because my mom told me to do that about a year ago. Then I was going to practice my tuba after I cleaned my room, but it was almost bedtime, so it was too late to practice my tuba. All week long, I had a lot of important stuff to do that made it impossible to practice my tuba. I had to make my bed. I had to floss my teeth. I had to line up my collection of pest dispensers in size order. You know, the important stuff. When I got to school the next Thursday, there were 16 geese out on the playground. 16! I counted them. They were multiplying. I didn't even know geese could do math. That's a joke, but seriously, not only were there geese multiplying, they were also dropping their geese poop all over the playground. It was gross. After we pledged allegiance, we went to room 03. Have you kids been practicing, Miss Bacon asked. As we walked in, I forgot, said Michael. I forgot, said Alexa. I forgot, said Ryan. I forgot, said Neil. And I forgot, said Emily. Miss Bacon didn't look happy. I've been practicing, shouted Andrea. Ugh. Okay, Miss Bacon, I said, let's try hot cross buns. I sat between Ryan and Little Miss Perfect. Miss Bacon waved her chopstick around and we played hot cross buns. It sounded horrible. No, shouted Miss Bacon, you're not feeling the buns. After we finished the song, Andrea leaned over to me. Hey, Arlo, she whispered, can you play solo? Sure, I said. Then why don't you play solo? We can't hear you. No, snap, said Ryan. Playing tuba is hard. You've got to push those buttons and blow into the mouthpiece and hold the big tuba up all at the same time. But Miss Bacon said I was making progress, and she gave me my yellow bow. Of course, Little Miss Know-It-All had already earned her yellow, orange, green, and blue belts. Why can't a truck full of hot cross buns fall on her head? After we played the song a few more times, Miss Bacon taught us a song with four notes. Mary Had a Little Lamb. That's a weird song. It's about a lamb that follows a girl to school. Why would a lamb go to school? If I was a lamb, I would just stand around eating grass all day. School is the last place I'd go. Besides, how would a barnyard animal get through school security? At my school, visitors can't come in unless they show their ID to Officer Spence, our security guard. If a lamb ever snuck into our school, there would be a lockdown. Officer Spence would probably shoot it with a tranquilizer dart. Anyway, after we learned Mary Had a Little Lamb, Miss Bacon taught us some other songs that don't have many notes in them. Row, row, row your boat, Dates Bitty Spotter, The Wheels on the Bus, and Bohemian Rhapsody. She said we would play all those songs on our big recital. It's only 2 weeks away. You know what? I have to admit, by the end of the class time, our little band was actually getting pretty good. You could also tell what song we were playing without being told the name of it. When we left the band room that day, Miss Bacon pulled me aside. She said I was doing a great job on the tuba, and she gave me another belt, the orange one. It's the greatest day of my life. Chapter 8, The Big Gig. When I got to school the next day, all the geese were gone from the playground. That was weird. Where did they go? Back to Canada, I guess. Big news, kids, said Miss Bacon when we got to room 303. We have our first gig this morning. When a group of musicians play in front of people, it's called a gig. Nobody knows why. I'm scared, said Emily. I just get scared of everything. There's no need to be nervous, said Miss Bacon. This is just a warm-up for our recital next week. Grab your instruments and pringle up. We walked 1,100,000 miles to the front of the school where the bus was waiting. Dingle boo, said Miss Cromwell, our bus driver. That means hello in her secret language. Miss Cromwell is not normal. We drove 1,100,000 minutes until we reached a big building. The sign on the front said Shady Rest Senior Home. We're going to play for senior citizens, Michael asked as we piled out of the bus. Yes, said Miss Bacon, but not just any senior citizens. You'll never believe who came out of Shady Rest Senior Home to greet us. It was elementary. The lady our school was named after. She must live there. This mentor was a teacher at our school a long time ago. I'm happy to welcome you kids to Shady Rest, said Miss Mentry. My friends and I can't wait to hear you play. We walked inside and Miss Mentry led us to a big room with bleachers. We climbed up the bleachers and unpacked our instruments. The senior citizens came to the room and sat in chairs. Some of them were already sitting in wheelchairs. Miss Mentry stood up and all the senior citizens clapped. My friends, she announced, I'm proud to introduce you to some of the wonderful students who attend the school that was named after me. These third graders would like to serenade you. This is their first concert ever. Woohoo! Some old guy shouted, rock and roll! Stairway to Heaven, somebody shouted, Pink Floyd, Freebird! I had no idea what they were shouting about. Miss Bacon waved her chopstick and we started playing Hot Cross Buns. We were all a little nervous, but if you ask me, we crushed it. Senior citizens gave us a nice roar of applause. I think they would have given us a standing ovation, but a lot of them couldn't stand up. AC/DC, shouted an old lady. More cowbell. Oops. Miss Bacon waved her chopstick, and we played Mary Had a Little Lamb. Again, we were awesome. While the senior citizens were cheering and clapping, Miss Bacon gathered us around her. Okay, she whispered, clean out your spit valves. Where, I asked. On the bleachers, she replied. Gross, who was I to argue? We emptied our spit valves and bleachers. And you'll never believe who walked in the door at that moment. Nobody, doors are made of wood. You can't walk through a piece of wood. What are you going to learn? But you'll never believe who opened the door and came into the room. It's Dr. Carbles, the president of the Board of Education. He walked in just as I was blowing a load of spit out of my tuba. Miss Bacon waved her chopstick and we started playing the Itsy Bitsy Spider. That's when the weirdest thing in the history of the world happened. Emily must have slipped on some slip because she stumbled a little. The end of her flute poked into the back of Alexa's head. Alexa screamed and the slide part of her trombone went flying. Got caught in Andrea's hair. She freaked out and bumped into me. I lost my balance and my tuba slammed into Ryan. His French horn fell on Michael's foot. Michael hopped up and banged into Neil, and then everyone fell off the bleachers, even Miss Bacon. The next thing we knew, all of us were tangled up in a big heap on the floor. Arms and legs and instruments were everywhere. Everyone was yelling and screaming and hooting and hollering and freaking out. Alexa's trombone slide was wrapped around Ryan's neck. Miss Bacon's head was poking through Neil's drum. He should have been there. It was redoinkless. When all this was happening, Dr. Carbles stood there looking really angry. Senior citizens clapped, but that was the end of our gig. We packed up our instruments and left the Shady Rest Senior Home. As we were walking out the door, Lanny handed me a note. It said, thank you for coming to play with us. I thought your music was wonderful. I showed it to Miss Bacon and asked her why a lady wrote a note instead of just telling me she liked our music. She was asleep the whole time, Miss Bacon told me. She didn't hear a note you played. Chapter 9, Spelling Counts. We climbed back onto the bus. Miss Bacon sat in the front row by herself. A few minutes later, I heard strange sounds coming from her seat. That's when I realized she was crying. I didn't think Miss Bacon was faking. We all went to the We all went to the front row of the bus to give her hugs and tissues. That's what you do when someone's crying. What's the matter, Miss Bacon? Asked Emily. Miss Bacon waved her face. I'm a big failure, she whimpered. Recital next week is going to be a disaster. I don't know what to do. Kids aren't ready. I only have half an hour a week to teach you how to play all the songs. It's not enough time. I'm not practicing at home. I'm stressed out. Dr. Carbles is going to fire me, and no one will ever hire me again. My career is over. She started crying again. Don't worry, Miss Bacon, said Andrea. Everything's going to be okay. We're going to put on a great show with the recital, said Alexa. Yeah, I added, we're going to make you proud of us. We're going to practice really hard. And we did. We practiced like crazy all week. I didn't waste my time playing video games or lining up my Pez dispensers. All I did was practice playing tuba. I played Hot Cross Buns so many times, I was beginning to feel the buns. Finally, the day of our big recital arrived. I had to wear a tie to school. Ugh, a sign in the front said we should walk around to the playground. There were a bunch of chairs set up out there and lots of grown-ups. Miss Bacon, Miss Klutz, Mr. Cooper, Mr. Loring, Dr. Carbles was there too with his mean face. "Such a beautiful day," said Miss Bacon. "Thought it'd be nice to have the recital outdoors." "I'm going to pass out." "She's going to pass out," I yelled. "Give her air." "I'm going to pass out programs," continued Miss Bacon. "I made them myself." Miss Bacon handed everyone one of her programs. People were ushered to their seats by the PTA. That stands for Parents Who Talk a Lot. Ryan's mom, Miss Doral, is president of the PTA. She was carrying a big platter. "Guess what I made," she said. "What?" everyone asked. "Hot cross buns," said Miss Dole. She passed out the buns to the audience, but we couldn't eat anything because it was our time to take place, our places on the stage. Bummer in the summer. "Are you nervous?" Ryan asked me as he picked up his French horn. "Yeah, we were all on pins and needles." "Well, not really. We were sitting on chairs. If we were all on pins and needles, it would have hurt. But there was electricity in the air." "Well, not really. If there was electricity in the air, we would all get electrocuted." Klutz held up his hand and made a peace sign, which means shut up. "Welcome to the third grade recital," he announced. "These students have been working very hard on the music, and they're excited to play for you today. Ready, kids?" Miss Bacon raised her chopsticks and we played Hot Cross Buns. It was great. After that, we played Mary Had a Little Lamb. It was awesome. We didn't miss a note. Parents were all smiling and clapping for us. It's the greatest day of my life. We took a minute to empty our spit valves. It was time to play Itsy Bitsy Spider. That's when the weirdest thing in the history of the world happened. I heard a noise in the distance. "Here's something," I whispered to Neil. "Yeah, what is it?" he whispered back. "It's me," I whispered. The noise was getting louder and closer. "What is that annoying sound?" asked Miss Bacon. "Look, up in the sky," shouted Ryan. I looked up. "It's a bird," shouted Michael. "No, it's a bunch of birds," shouted Alexa. That's when I realized it was the geese. They were coming back. There were dozens of them flying in a big V shape, honking and squawking like crazy. "They're headed this way," shouted Andrea. She was right. The birds were coming right at us. I saw it with my own eyes. Well, it'd be pretty hard to see something in someone else's eyes. "We've got nothing. We've got to do something," shouted Emily. "Help," somebody screamed. "The geese are attacking," I shouted. "No, they're not," shouted Andrea. "That's their mating call. They must have heard us playing and they fell in love with our instruments." "Run for your lives," shouted Neil. The next thing we know, the geese were dive bombing and landing all over us. "A bird pooped on my flute," shouted Emily. "Help," I shouted. "I think a goose fell in love with my tuba." "Geese are eating my hot cross buns," shouted Miss Dole. "Protect the buns." Miss Dole was out of control. Everyone was yelling and screaming and hooting and hollering and freaking out. Emily slipped on some spit and fell off the stage. Parents were jumping off their seats. It was ridiculous. Miss Glutz hollered for us to get into the school right away. After everyone was safe inside, Dr. Carble slammed the door so the geese couldn't follow us. He looked really mad. "That's the last straw," he shouted, "Miss Bacon. You're fired." Chapter 10, One Woman Band. What do straws have to do with anything? And why are grown-ups always running out of them? Can't they just buy a new box of straws before the old box is empty? It's really sad that Miss Bacon got fired. It made for a sad ending to the story. But hey, who decided that stories have to have a happy ending anyway? Actually, the next day, the weirdest thing in the history of the world happened. The guys and I were going to get ice cream cones after school when we saw Miss Bacon standing on the corner by herself. She had a drum strapped to her back, a trumpet, a kazoo in front of her face, a cymbal on her head, a tambourine on her knee, and a violin in her hands. Oh, and she'd be a smile on her face, and you'll never believe what song she was playing. Hot cross buns. Well, that's pretty much what happened. Maybe Miss Bacon will get her job back. Maybe I'll earn my black belt. Maybe they'll have music on Uranus. Maybe I'll play the tuba in my ears. Maybe musicians will stop emptying their spit valves all over the floor. Maybe Officer Spence will shoot the lamb with the tranquilizer dart. Maybe Miss Bacon will go get Chinese food. Maybe I can talk somebody into putting ridiculous into the dictionary. But it won't be easy. That's the end of Miss Bacon's Faking. I hope you enjoyed.